Alright, here I am back with another gaming vlog for this week. Yep, today is September 14th, 2022. I am about to... Yep. Yep, I'm about to play some more Sega Saturn. I'm gonna do this once more. Yeah, figured I'd play more of the old stuff for a while. Knock myself out with them. Not gonna be doing my emulators today, but yeah, I'm gonna probably just do a wide mix of gaming today. Sega Saturn, been playing my Nintendo Switch too. I've got Calabunga Collection on there still. Yeah, we're gonna play the mediocre Batman Forever on the Sega Saturn, the arcade game. Yep. Pretty amazing on how, like, Batman Forever is, like, one of the best Batman movies, but their games, like, really, really choke. Now, I really wish they'd bring that old DC logo back. That DC logo they had in the 90s, that was the best one they ever had. Really wish they'd bring that one back. Some of the other ones were okay, but I think the one they had, like, in the 90s, the circle and the stars, and it, DC letters as, like, the bestest one they ever came up with. Yeah, you hear Chris O'Donnell's voice say Robin like he did in the Batman Forever movie. Loading. Yeah, loading. Loading, please wait. Yeah, I'll wait. Get used to these controls here. All right. Gotham News Network was on in the background, I think. The GNN. Yeah, I noticed in Batman Forever, yeah, like when they had the Gotham News Network, they used similar font to what CNN used. Because it's a Warner, well, a Turner station and all that, and they've been in cahoots with Warner Brothers stuff for a long time. But I tell you, the way these distributions work, they're pretty complex. Yeah, and it's pretty amazing, and I like, very much like the Andy Griffith Show, how Seinfeld remained on TBS in terms of its reruns and all that. It's good to know I haven't even died yet. Haven't lost any lives. Oh boy. Come on, Robin. Remember those circus acrobatic moves. You gotta jump a lot. Normally, I'm too lazy to jump in games anymore unless I'm playing Mario or Sonic. Oh boy, let me go, you idiot. Oh. Lost Bat Bowl opportunity, boy, I can't believe it. Oh boy, alright. so psyched about Gotham Knights coming out. I'm buying it on day one next month. Yeah, and apparently the developers said that they're making a Harley Quinn scenario. I looked it up this morning on a YouTube video. Yeah, it's pretty amazing on how we're so close to the release date, and yeah, they've added a few new features in the development. Yeah, maybe if the Harley Quinn scenario is already finished and complete by release day, you might even end up getting it with the deluxe edition. That's the version of the game I plan to get. Highest round score is what I'm going with. I actually kind of figured out the other day that how to get far into this game is to do the pick the highest round score bonus. It's what's worked for me anyway. Oh boy, I lost again. Usually it's a lot sooner than this in the game where I have to, yeah, alright. Come on. That to my advantage, oh yes. See a soda machine right there? Well, she looks like Poison Ivy in this game, it's incredible. That girl right there who's like one of the thugs, it's amazing. Oh man. The sound went out again like before, oh boy. Hasn't done that in a while. But yeah, I mean, pretty amazing. I like how people tend to like even say a lot of stuff about Batman and Robin, but you know, even Batman and Robin was a pretty good Batman movie also. I mean, it wasn't as good as Batman Forever or Batman 89, but I mean, I personally even think it's a better Batman movie than Batman Returns. I mean, that's just my subjective opinion. I'm in the minority, I know that. But, yeah, just saying, I mean, because, I mean, Batman and Robin still had a pretty incredible detailed plot and everything, and it was a plot that was sensible. I mean, even Arnold Schwarzenegger did bring out one of his finest movie performances. Yeah, sorry if I'm a little at a loss for words. It's just that I've kind of been a little bit sick lately because yeah. Oh boy. Oh boy, and game went out on me. Oh boy, I probably said it. I just have to reset the game. I don't know why it's doing that, but yeah, we're gonna have to start the game over again. Oh. Yeah, I got this game for Christmas. Ordered it off the internet and got more Sega Saturn stuff I'm gonna probably play at a little later on anyway, so Again, that's like one of the finest DC comic logos ever. But yeah, I mean, this is the thing, you know, about it, you know, I mean, there, yeah, I mean, I think even, like, according to a map in my area, there have been a growing number of COVID cases around. Yep. I think I kind of even figured something out, that if I can make that purple bar, like, grow really, really up, I could get another power up. Oh, yes. Get me those, huh? Great goodness. Already lost a life. Here we go again. Let's go. My goodness. Finally, I got the grapple. I didn't get the grapple last time. I was that unfortunate not to get it. Goodness. Come on. Oh. Yes, heck yes. I used to be in the circus. I was one of the Flying Graysons. Doesn't my suit give it away? Ha, oh, yeah. You should know I'm not lying. No. Yep, that's the one I'm sticking with. But yeah, I mean, it's good to know that I've at least been wearing a mask, been trying to take some cough drops if my throat feels a little funny. This is the part where it glitched out before, I think. Close to it. That's one down, two more to go. Kind of name is Flex anyway. Alright, got fortunate enough that time. The music and sound didn't silence, the game didn't glitch. Just pretty amazing on how, like, over 8 years ago, like, going on, kind of, a little going on nine, well, I mean, it'll be, like, 9 years this, like, May, April or something, and I've had this console. I can imagine how much older it was before I bought it, though. Down you guys go. Thank you. Down you go. Oh man, another life lost again. Yeah, I watched AEW Dynamite, been catching up on both Dynamite and Rampage. Watched the most recent episode of Dynamite from last week on the DVR, and looked like CM Punk once again had to relinquish the title. Yeah, now they're having a tournament for who will become champion this time. Yeah, as well as the fact that it's almost like Tony Khan. I don't know what's gotten into him. What he is with all this creative stuff and all that, because he's also doing a tournament for the Trios Championships. Well, actually, no, that's already finished. But he crowned new Trios Champions. You know, Penta, Rey Fénix, and Pac, they're the Trios Champions as of right now over in AEW. Yeah, I like a lot of what Penta did over in Lucha Underground as Pentagon Jr. and Dark. He even had the very big championship reign that was iconic there. He probably made more out of that thing than Prince Puma Ricochet did. Seemed like he had more value to it, even though Ricochet, Prince Puma did have a pretty good reign with it too, but it's like Penta seemed to be a little bit more, well, he took more pride in being the Lucha Underground champion, or at least so it looked like. Especially seeing as the fact that when Ricochet was playing the Prince Puma gimmick, he was focusing more on his street fighting style rather than his wrestling skills. And that's like one of the reasons why I think people often forget that he was Prince Puma and Lucha Underground, and that he's had a lot more of a successful career in WWE, but I digress on that though. But it was good to know that he had the Intercontinental Championship for a while until he lost it to Gunther. I'm not sure about the overall results there. I can't even say. I know Sheamus was supposed to fight Gunther for it last time. I know Shinsuke Nakamura choked to him, but I guess this time they really want to push that Austrian tall man. Pretty amazing on how Butch, who used to be Pete Dunne in NXT and NXT UK, he ended up getting a victory over Ludwig Kaiser, formerly Marcel Bartel. Marcel Bartel. Say that. Yeah, I know. I mean, he started breaking fingers again. And now with Triple H in charge, you never know, they might start using their old NXT names. Yeah, it's pretty amazing on how even Raw and SmackDown have been more watchable even compared to what they were years ago, because Triple H is in charge and he always knew what it took to put on a good wrestling show when he had control over NXT, and he's doing just that for Raw and SmackDown, which is actually pretty incredible. It's like, you know, it allows you to come back for more and everything, and you don't want to always criticize it. Still pretty cool over at AEW how Toni Storm is the women's champ over there. Yeah, she definitely deserves to hold on to it for Thunder Rosa while she recuperates. After all, she has a history with her, it looks like. Crap, man! Yeah, quote from Batman Forever movie when the Riddler intruded into the Batcave. Intruder alert, intruder alert, shut up. Yeah, as for that Batman Forever podcast when me and my brother were watching the movie, it's like, you know, that apparently that microphone ain't really as good as you would think. I mean, seems like you have to turn the volume up real loud or wear headphones to hear the commentary in there. Yeah, maybe I should have used, like, something else. Like, yeah, I'll try to do some better methods next time in order to have the sound louder, hopefully. Man, that PC desktop that I have, I've had that thing for a long time. I've had it for 11 years. At some point, I plan to possibly get me another desktop that's new and improved, and one that I can do some PC gaming on it, maybe from like a website like Steam or something, because I was thinking about getting a Steam account, but I hear, according to some, that it's not really as good of a place to do PC gaming as it used to be. Oh man, they ambushed me before I could throw it on them. Alright. man, yeah, like... Oh man, I just hope that, oh wait, yeah, good, I was going to say, is that officially game over now? I was thinking about maybe playing this maybe just one more time, but since I had that little disruption, I'll probably just call out the, if I get game over this time, it stays that way. You go. Yin Yang bonus, oh yeah. Yeah, let's do this one this time. Finally, we completed that level too. Two Faces Hideout, we have to fight Sugar and Spice. Sugar down, spice to go. Bonus bat, but it's kind of funny because I normally don't make it this far into the game. It's kind of hard to even make it this far. Not to mention them, how like too many people are attacking you at once in this game and stuff. It can be very difficult to tell whether or not you're winning or losing at times when you're playing this. Kind of looks a little like the Batman villain Anarchy. Game over. Alright. Well, yeah, I know. I've been lucky a few times while playing this. I played this game some more the other day, and gotta say, it'll probably be a long time before I ever make it to the end of this. Well, anyway, I'll save the high scores. Alright. Now I guess we'll play something else. Yeah, I'm gonna play Mortal Kombat 3 on the Sega Saturn here. Prepare for combat. Mortal Kombat! Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 on the Sega Saturn. This game still is very hard on very easy, so, wait for it to load. See how lucky I get here, because normally playing Mortal Kombat on the Sega Saturn or Genesis can be a tough deal, but I personally found Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 to be even harder on the Super Nintendo, regardless of the worst controls for Sega. Yeah, Sektor's one of the bestest cyborg characters to pick in the franchise. I love the fact that Sektor has that, like, missile and all that. I know on Super Nintendo and Genesis version, you can even, like, aim it and stuff. Not really, they're very good at doing the brutalities and fatalities. I normally get lucky and do those, and unless I'm playing MK11 as the Joker on the DLC. Can't wait to find out what else is in store for Mortal Kombat. See Cyrax in the background, like, drowning in the quicksand at this level. I think that's supposed to be, like, an illusion. Down you go, reptile. Gotta go up against Shiva. I think Sektor's finally met his match. What I actually said was true. As Sektor, I have met my match. Now there's a final round going up next. Well, that does it for this part. I'm going to continue, and I guess I'll probably pick somebody else. See how Nightwolf does with the spiritual arrow against the multiple armed woman. Thank you. goodness. Whoa, boy. Ironic, because the next opponent up is Nightwolf, so it'll be a mirror match next. Probably decent to say, you know, that I do still have some pretty good battery power in that. I've got a few more batteries. I could probably make a whole entire gaming vlog for this evening on that thing. Still haven't made any movie reviews yet for a while, but probably be working on that soon. Maybe for like the month of October, I might even do some scary movies. Like, I'll watch a scary movie on like a Saturday, since those are usually my days I watch movies now. And I'll watch a horror flick, or maybe even like a scary movie or a Halloween movie for children. I actually am thinking about maybe reviewing the movie Casper from 1995. As well as I still have big plans to review one of my all-time favorite horrors of all, Silence of the Lambs. About Hannibal Lecter, played by Anthony Hopkins. What do you know? Killed by my mirror double. Yeah, I'll use up these last three credits here and, yeah, I guess after this, maybe I'll, I don't know if I'll play another Saturn game or not, but we'll see. Yeah, let's see if his hat of death will prevail against Nightwolf. It's actually a pretty good matchup right here, Kung Lao versus Nightwolf. This is a very big equivalent match right here. Be perfectly honest, I think Kung Lao and Nightwolf would probably be a better person for Kung Lao to pair up with, even though compared to Liu Kang, I would think. Like, say hypothetically, Liu Kang wanted to permanently team up with Johnny Cage. Kung Lao would probably turn to Nightwolf, I would kind of think. On top of that, good thing for Kung Lao, he'd be the one in charge of the duo, too, I would think. Like, the brains and leader. Now you have Cabal, who's obviously very fast in speed. That could have went either way. Cabal was no trouble at all for Kung Lao. Oh boy, now there's another mirror battle right here. Wonder if I'll be able to get out of this one. And then there's an endurance round after this. Prepare for the next fighter. Who is it, Sonya? Nightwolf. Boy, I never would have thought. Boy, didn't even come close that time. Oh my goodness. Oh boy. Got 2 credits left, so... Yeah, they want a ninja Sub-Zero on here, just a unmasked Sub-Zero. Yeah, I was gonna pick Smoke anyway. Pick another Cyborg. Oh man, here it comes. I know, yeah, but I'm not thinking King, although I have Liu Kang this time. Hold on just a minute, I gotta do the call of nature and check on a couple things real fast. Alright, I am back. Yep, I am back and yeah, I'm gonna play some more Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 on the Sega Saturn. Okay, here we go again. yeah, this is the last go, and yeah, if I don't win this, I already know what happens. Oh man. Well, that's it here. Yep, game over already. Right. Okay. Yeah. May I play some Nintendo Switch stuff? Alright. Make sure everything's.
Oh yeah, absolutely, definitely right here. Alright.
Okay. Play some Cowabunga Collection. Thing. It's how we used to have to play it back in the day, was on channel 3 or tuning the TV into it. Okay. Original Ninja Turtles arcade game. Yeah, you can get them to say Cowabunga 1,000 times. Here we go. Fire! Hang on, April. Yeah, you dig the opener right there. Mm. Yeah, imagine if Beavis and Butthead were playing this game, you hear Beavis saying right now, fire, fire. I will resist you, but I will not resist pizza. Steady. Yeah, so I'm playing Batman Forever, the arcade games. You can't make it far there, you can make it all the way on this. Oh gosh, down again. old Baxter Stockman.
Oh, yeah.
Gotta stop him again. Oh man, I should have moved out of the way. I was too busy still attacking. Oh. Actually watched the fourth episode of Picard yesterday, and at the very end of it, Seven of Nine ended up appearing at the very end of the episode. Jerry Ryan from Voyager. Yeah, I think I already actually knew that Seven of Nine was supposed to appear in the first season of Picard. And a lot of rumors going around that in the third season, Captain Sisko may appear finally, because probably in the form of the emissary of the prophets, because on the very last episode of Deep Space Nine, after the Dominion War was over, he ascended. I can't wait to see how that's going to pan out between Sisko and Picard, since the two of them kind of have bad blood. I mean, it was an intense relationship between them, and not in a very so positive way. Yeah, the Battle of Wolf 359. Yeah, Battle of Wolf 359. Sisko was a part of that. And he lost his wife, Jennifer. And Captain Picard had been assimilated by the Borg. And he was Locutus. hand. I keep getting my butt whooped. Staying away from down there. Rock Soldier from Dimension X. Who would have thought Shredder and Krang would go this far? Down you go. Thank you. will resist you, but I will not resist pizza. It's what Leonardo or any of the turtles would say to those roadkill Rodneys. Oh man, just when I was avoiding those freezing sprays, I get shocked instead by many volts of power. Oh. Oh man, goodness. Down you go. Down you go again. Absolutely. Yeah, you gotta once again fight Shredder. Yeah, I tell you, in the 1987 Ninja Turtles series, you know, it seems like Shredder didn't take his helmet and mask off a whole lot in that series, but you saw him in, like, several episodes with it off. He took off his entire costume and just dressed it in like, a button-up shirt, you know, and dress pants and everything, and went down to Florida to recruit those, like, toads to help him defeat the turtles and everything. That was a pretty iconic moment where you saw Shredder without his costume, not wearing the helmet or the mask either, let alone. Yeah, he obviously did that because he had to go all the way to, like, the swamps of Florida, like the Everglades, and he didn't want to draw attention. Yeah, I'd say even a hunter would have probably dared to shoot him if they saw him in his gear and his helmet. Do another one from another collection here. Mario 3D All-Stars. Yeah, one of the best collection classic sets that came out in the middle of the pandemic, I must say. Been 20 years since this came out. Turned 20 a couple so weeks ago. Yeah, sorry if my vocabulary is a little off. It's just that I've been a little under the weather and have been mildly sick over the last week. A lot of people passing on germs, and I think there's like a rise of COVID cases in my area, apparently. Looked it up on the map this morning, that explained it all. But anyway, yeah, just wanted to... I don't have time to play the whole game, but I actually started playing some of this again last night. I just pick up on the game I was playing that I have already started on here. I actually had this game on the GameCube for a while. When I had a GameCube, I don't have my GameCube anymore, but You know, when I had a GameCube, I actually had this game for it, though, and it was worth it, too. Never exactly, knew how to beat it yet, but... This is a pretty good Mario game from what I've played of it, though. I mean, it's no Mario 64, but it's still a pretty cool game, though. Oh boy, it's been ages since I played this. Can't remember exactly where those red coins are located, but I'm gonna look for them. The red coin ain't there. Valuable blue coin coming up. Oh. Yeah, it makes three of them I've found. Okay, now we gotta get three more. Okay, where are those other two red coins at? Thank you. Okay, now where could that last red coin be? Oh, yeah, we just gotta find it. Again. Okay, right there we are. Shine Sprite away. They got it. Huh. Yeah, I'll admit, you know, I mean, sure, this game has its flaws compared to Mario 64, but the fact that you have, like, a cool water jetpack and squirt gun, such as Flop, kind of makes it all worthwhile. Coming back for more and all that, too. Oh, man, I keep messing up at that part, though. Man. Goodness. It's too bad I can't just go in the water and restore my health like in Mario 64, boy. I'm having a hard time getting to that shine sprite. They put it in a bad location. ran off. I ran right out of water. Oh man. Oh, yes. I got the Shine Sprite, but boy, they put it in the worst of places. Check out this little, it's a puddle of tar right here. Definitely resembles tar. Well, man, I stepped on the tar. Oh. Here it goes. It's Petey the Tar Piranha. Oh no. Oh Okay, we got another stage unlocked. Delano Beach, Dune Bud Sandcastle Secret. What do you know, a secret one for the start off of the scenario? But then again, is it so secret after all, because it's just right there in the middle of the sand? There is Shadow Mario again. These are the worst. Oh man! Yeah, that's the thing, those are the worst. But anyway, I think in the meantime, I'm going to end this blog journal of a random gaming blog on September 14th, 2022. I will be back at some point. See ya.